read that, I had to double check everything. I'm like, my gosh. I mean, you came from Detroit, Cass Tech.
Yes.
Coach Pope also Cass Tech alum. Did that, how much did that weigh into you deciding for Coppin over other schools?
Well, for me, the reason why I chose Coppin was because not only did Coach Pope come there, we both were coached by the same person. So we know, you know, the work ethic that I already have and that I would put into the program. And going in, I did look up the record, and I wasn't happy with that. And I felt like this was the opportunity for me to come here to change the program, and that's what my goal was.
Jacket feels good on you?
It does.
You talk about changing the program around. You know, just listening to people, it seemed like the first thing you did was change yourself around, transform your body from a high school athlete to a Division I athlete.
Yes. My first game, I was a little nervous, of course, because the game was more fast-paced when I was in high school. And in high school, I had to pitch from 40 feet, from pitchers' mounds to home plate. In college, it's 43. So I had to make a huge adjustment. And it wasn't just mentally, but it was physically, spiritually, and emotionally. And in order for me to do that, I knew during the first game, I knew I could change the program. So immediately after, I went to weight room, I ran, I did my workouts. I even went to the gym and I asked the sports facility management team to open up the gym. They gave me the balls and I just went to work.
You're talking about the adjustment you made in the circle, but what about at the plate? Because you had major contributions as a hitter too. What kind of adjustment was that?
For me, of course, because the ball came a lot faster and the movements of each pitch was completely different, I really had to zone in and work on my fundamentals. And what my high school coach told me was work on fundamentals. And what he used to say was basic by fundamental bread. So every time I would do too much or I would overthink it, I will start by the first step and then work my way up, and that's how
I'm going to be successful. One thing I remember about Coppin, I still remember names of professors here. They had a huge impact on my life. Any stories like that with professors here?
Yes. So I actually keep a lot of sayings from my professor. He used to tell me, get the biggest bang for your buck. And with Coppin being a university, it was also a job. So because I was on full scholarship, I knew that I had to produce full scholarships here. So every time you say that, I will always go back to that saying, even in the classroom, I'm paying for this, I'm working for this. So it's the opportunity for me to learn more and come here and do what I'm supposed to do and get a degree in sports medicine.
Now, you were a two-time MEAC Pitcher of the Year, 2010 and 12. Mm-hmm. What did that mean to you?
It means a lot because I didn't know those types of awards were given for MEAC. And since our freshman year, we didn't make it. That fueled me even more to go home and work even harder. And when I was first told that I got that award, I cried. One, because the work it took for me to, you know, accomplish what I did, but because I brought Coppin back to life. And that was my goal, and to be able to reach that my sophomore year, it made me feel happy to feel.
How does Coppin change your life? I mean, you're putting on this Hall of Fame jacket. Number one, did you ever think coming here from Detroit, one day you'd be severe?
No, I didn't, but my sophomore year, when the fall season started, we went to the basketball game just before it was time for us to go to practice. And we had to sit at the top so we could be able to, you know, make a feeling time. And I remember it was a Hall of Fame induction, and it was a track lady. And, you know, at first, I didn't really pay attention to it because I was just focused on what we were going to do in practice. But when I heard the athletic director say Hall of Fame nominees, I zoned in. And right then, I zoned in into that moment and seeing the four nominees on the floor, their homecoming, and telling their story. And I remember that, like, yesterday. I said, wow, I want to do that. Like, that's where I should be. And I really worked hard for it.
What is Paige Arnold doing now?
Right now, I am a mother of three girls. They're over there. And,
All right.
I have a three-year-old, a four-year-old, and a six-year-old. And I'm in nursing school to be a labor and delivery nurse and a midwife. And I am in the process of joining the National Air Guard, so I'll be serving there.